Hey guys, welcome back to another vlog. This video is a bit special. It's an unboxing video. Never done an unboxing video before, but it's a first for everything. It's quite special actually. So it was my birthday a few days ago, and my wife's got me a Cirtate 2500D, and I'm pretty stoked. I would have probably never bought one anytime soon, so I've got to say I'm really, really happy about it. And I thought I'll do an unboxing video and just share my journey with you guys. So that's a plan. I hope you guys like it. So yeah, stay tuned. We'll just keep it raw, keep it natural. I'm not going to specify all the techs and whatnot because, like I said, I've never done an unboxing video before. I just want to show you guys what I'm looking at, point of view sort of thing, opening up such a nice high-end special reel. So I will include some tech specs below in a URL link if you guys want the full specs, but I'll just run through it nice and slow and simple. And yeah, let's get started. So I'll just flip the camera around. Boom, there she is, Cirtate 2500D LT. So quite a special reel. Let's just open that up. Bit of ASMR. All right, so she did buy it from Rockdale Fishing, which is, should come up there. So she bought it from Rockdale Fishing, which is a pretty awesome tackle shop. And he has put it on the box there. Probably would have liked it without that, but I'm not really that fussy. Let's just unbox this, eh? Let's see what it comes with. All right, first up, 5-year warranty, which is awesome. Gives you all the details, yada, yada, yada. Boom. Special nice bag. No Daiwa logos on it, but it's a nice looking bag. Guessing the reel's inside there. Before we get to the reel, let's see what else it comes with. It comes with an instruction manual. And there we go, a few washers. So anything else? Nothing else. That's about it. Pretty simple. Let's open up the bag. So I am using one hand. What I might do, give me a second, guys. Well, that worked. All right, so what's in the bag? It is the 2500 Cirtate. There we have it. That is beautiful. Have a look at that, guys. Nicely designed, really simple. But yeah, really nice feel in the hands. Nice and light, but also a bit tough, you know, it is a Cirtate. Got a nice handle there, actually. So it's got a really nice finish. And it's just got the T handle. So the 25D and the 25XH, which is a high speed, comes with the T handle. But the 25S, which is the shallow spool, comes with the I handle. So yeah, let's put that on. Can't wait to feel how smooth this is. Tighten it up. That's pretty tight. Is there any play in there? Just as I thought, no play at all. So no play at all. Any play in the spool? No play in the spool. Let's give it a quick spin. Oh wow. Wow, wow, wow. I can't believe how smooth that is. I cannot believe how smooth that is. Now, I'm not gonna lie, I felt how the 5000 spins and I was really, really happy with it, but this 2500 is just as good. Such a smooth reel, so. Let's check out the drag. That sounds pretty awesome. Not complaining about that. Not complaining about that at all. And yeah, there she is, 2500D Cirtate. I think it's a 2019 model. Let's get into a few specs. Keep it simple though. We'll get into a few specs. All right, so now that I've sort of had a fiddle with it, let's get into a few tech specs and just try to keep it as simple as we can. It comes with a mag sealed body, and it also states it somewhere on the reel. the infamous mag sealed. There we have it right there. Infamous mag sealed dial was known for. And also the monocoque design finish, which is right there, as you can see. It's also good for the bigger gears to sit better, so it's just like a one piece sort of monocoque design, which is amazing, man. It looks amazing actually, and it helps them put a bigger gear that releases more torque. And yeah, that's basically it as for the design part. As for the spool, as you can see, it's really deep, so I'm going to be able to fit a lot of line on that. I haven't decided what line to put yet, but I might put an 8 to 10 pound. If I can go PE 0.8, regardless, 8 or 10 pound, I might do so. But I haven't figured that out yet. So it is a deep spool. Sounds pretty good. The top of the part's plastic. It's not steel, but it still looks pretty good. Let's just take that apart. You know what? Oh, it does say dial on it actually. Thought he didn't, so there we go. It's a nice bag. All right, let's pull this apart. Yeah. Looks interesting. So that's pretty clean. See how it spins. Gotta say, I'm pretty stoked with this. I'm like a kid in a candy store, but that looks pretty good. Not gonna lie, I can't wait to use it. Like I said, I'm not gonna get into a lot of specs, but I will say I'm really stoked. These grooves here as well. So these grooves, are they made for anything? No, they're just a design. So there's no gaps in between that spool. It's just a groove that they've done, and it doesn't really make a difference in performance wise, so that's more so design. So it states the pounds for nylon and the pounds for braid right there, which I will include in the description, but stated on the reel there as it should be. Also comes with a mag sealed line roller. It's just a whole metal body, so like the whole reel is, it feels finesse, but it is a metal body, so you can use it for brim fishing obviously, but it's not as light as the Luvius. I've got a Cowdia, I've got a Tere Black, I've got the Tere Soul. It's not as light as those reels, but in saying that, it's still light. So I think it's only around 10 grams up from those sort of mid-range reels. We'll still use this for brim fishing, even though I might be targeting like, you know, light tackle kings, light tackle Jews, or big flathead or whatever it may be. I still will use this as a finesse reel. Even though it isn't really a finesse reel, it has that finesse feeling. And even the drag is a bit, the drag feels a bit finessey too. So it doesn't feel like you're holding a beast of a reel in your hand, although it does carry a lot of strength. So that's why it's an LT model, I guess. It's something like, I don't know how to explain it. You know, lightweight, but can handle a lot of balls sort of type reel. If that's one way to explain it, I don't know. All right, so just to finalize this unboxing, which is pretty basic. It's not like some special unboxing. I'm not a gearhead. I don't know too much about all these technical sort of things that exist in a reel, but I'm just here to show you guys what I've received as a gift from my lovely wife, as a birthday present. But just to finalize it, so it does have a 5:1 ratio in regards to the gear ratios, and it does weigh 205 grams. So like I said, it's not your finesse 180 gram, 170 gram sort of reel, but it still does feel a bit finessey, even though it is a strong reel. And max drag capacity is 10 kilos. So basically the 2500D and the high speed 2500XH is 10 kilos max drag, but the shallow spool is 5 kilos of max drag. So yeah, it has a 28.7 inch speed ratio sort of thing, 73 centimeters or something. So each retrieve is 73 centimeters. So it's quite fast, but it's not the high speed. I didn't get the high speed. And yeah, it does take PE. It's made for PE1, PE1.5 braid on the deeper spool, which means you're gonna get up to like 12 pound braid or 12 pound mono. And it does fit around 230 meters on the PE 1.5, and it fits in 360 meters on the PE1, which is pretty awesome. So if you're looking to put a lot of line on your reel, look to get a 2500D, which is what I have on me at the moment. So if you're not looking to pack the reel with a lot of line, the shallow spool could be a better option. It does weigh the same, so I would have exchanged it for the shallow spool if the shallow spool weighed slightly lighter, but I don't see a reason to use a shallow spool when I can just use the deeper spool, unless I was putting straight fluoro on it or something and I needed 150 meters of fluoro, but it's not going to be the case here. So yeah, that's about it, guys. I hope you like this unboxing. It is a quick and simple unboxing, but I thought I'd share it with you guys. And yeah, the design is it's really nice and simple. In all honesty, if you like simplicity, just have a look at it. It's just simple, basic, but does look high end. It does have that high end feel, and it does have that high end look. And yeah, that's about it, guys. Hope you like this unboxing. It is my first one, so I hope you guys liked it. I didn't run through all the specs. Probably a bit nervous doing an unboxing. I'm usually out there flicking my rod and fishing, but yeah, I can't wait to use it. Can't wait to get this thing tied up with some line. Can't wait to throw it out, and hopefully I can catch some good fish on it. But yeah, click the link below, subscribe, leave a comment, and see you guys later. Peace out.